Solving equations by factoring, the zero product rule. The zero product rule simply says that if we have two things times each other and it equals zero, then either A has to equal zero or B equals zero. One or the other has to equal zero. To solve a quadratic like what we're talking about, we're going to set each factor equal to zero and then solve. Here's another reason to learn factoring. So let's take a look at our examples here. They've been really nice to us here, and they already have them factored, so we don't have to do that. I'm going to set each factor equal to zero. That means I'm taking 5x minus 1 equal to zero and 2x plus 5 equal to zero. Okay, so starting with the first one, we're going to add 1 to both sides. Leaves me with 5x equal to 1. Divide by 5, and I get x equals 1/5. Let's solve the second one. I'm going to subtract 5 from both sides. I now have 2x equal to negative 5. Divide by 2. And x equals negative 5/2. So that means my solutions for this particular problem is x equal to 1/5 and negative 5/2. Let's take a look at example 2. In example 2, I have 3 factors. I have the 2x equal to 0, x minus 6 equal to 0, and 2x plus 3 equal to 0. So we solve for the first one by dividing by 2, and we get x is equal to 0. 0 divided by any number, remember, is 0. Go to the second one. I'll add 6 to both sides, and I get x is equal to 6. Go to my third one. I'll subtract 3 from both sides. I get 2x equal to negative 3. Divide by 2. And x is going to equal a negative 3/2. Notice that I have 3 answers. I had 3 factors. If we had multiplied this out, we would have gotten a 4x cubed for our first term. We're going to have the same number of answers as the highest exponent. If we had multiplied the first one out, we would have had 10x squared for our highest exponent. And we had 2 answers there, 3 answers for this one. You're always going to have the same number of answers as the highest exponent.